All right, welcome everybody to the second round after we got thoroughly smashed by a mono red deck. Probably should fix this actually. This should probably just be a swamp. We only have one red card in our deck. Decent start here. We got turn four Mole Drifter. Go for the throat. My opponent might be mono black here. You never know. Oh, blue black. Alright. There's a handful of counters that get this. Mana Leak, Negate, and Rune Snag. Jace, Shadow Mage. Alright, well, just gonna go ahead and get rid of this, as I have no way to block it, and then we're gonna just go ahead and, if my opponent has a counterspell for this, that's fine. It allows me to resolve my Mole Drifter. Okay, so Planeswalkers and Confiscate. My opponent's a little far away from that. They can just go ahead and Bloodstain Mire, Fatal Push. They can play Jace. Let's have Liliana. They have a lot of goodies here. Not going to take the Fatal Push. It's one of these three cards. I do have a Ruinous Path for one of the Planeswalkers. Confiscate is a ways away, but when my opponent gets to resolve it, it is kind of annoying. So what's my opponent's game plan here? If I take the Confiscate, they likely will go Jace plus with a land, then Liliana. But is that a big deal? So if they go Jace plus, then I attack it for two, goes down to two. Next turn I play Mole Drifter. Then if my opponent pluses and kills Vendilion Click, this thing's kind of annoying. But again, Confiscate is also pretty good against me. I don't have any bounce in my deck. And I'm just thinking long term, like the fact that my opponent can steal any of my win conditions. So I'm actually going to take the Confiscate, because I think it's going to be really hard for us to beat. Whereas at least I have a Ruinous Path for the Planeswalker. I mean, if my opponent just goes Jace into, like, my opponent can just go Jace plus, Jace minus, then Liliana. Oh, sorry, it goes to three. What am I saying? Well, fortunately, we can get the Fatal Push out of our opponent's hand now. Well, that's a nice hand. All right. Okay, so plus. So maybe they go Island Liliana. Okay, well, we got the Ruinous Path. I will discard the Archive. And I think I'm just going to Awaken, actually. So let's just go ahead and kill the Liliana. Awaken onto the Springs. And then have these attack Jace. So now Jace won't get my opponent any value, and yeah. There's the Mire. My opponent might Cryptic here. So So I don't want to play the Night's Whisper. If I do that, my opponent can just counter and tap my team. Let's draw some cards. Metamorph. Yes. I want to do that. All the value. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so we have 8 mana for Nicol Bolas. It's kind of tempoing our opponent right now. Massacre Worm seems pretty mediocre here. But probably going to replace it with Runescar Demon and Teferi. Is it Damnation? Oh no, that would be really bad. Okay, that's not too bad. All right. Well, let's just go ahead and see if this resolves. And then make our decisions afterwards. The Bolas Father. Look, if planeswalkers are going to be duking it out, you know, you got to go with the most powerful planeswalker of all time. I wonder if Dark Intimations is in this. They saved it with a bounce spell. Okay. So now we know the coast is clear. I was actually going to attack Jace with all of my creatures, but now I'm just going to go click Moldrifter to Jace, and then this to my opponent. Yep, I'm glad I took the Confiscate. My opponent does seem to have a pretty decent control deck. I mean, it looks pretty well positioned for the mirror, at least. Whoa, my opponent drew 4 cards. That's pretty good. All right. Attack Liliana. Or attack Tamiya. I guess this man. Attack Liliana. Attack our opponent. Let's kill that. I should have cracked this first. See what I draw. Ooh. I want more information. My opponent might just concede here, though. Unless they have an answer to Nicol Bolas. Oh my god! Oh, that's insane! Ultimate! Oh my god! Wow! Sack 7 permanents, huh? Oh my goodness. We're only at 4. 5. Oh my goodness. So I'm going to be left with Sulphurous Springs, Sheldock Isle, Chromatic Lantern. I think I won 4 mana. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So I can sack one more land. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then... Wow! That was absurd. I wonder, like, there is a bit of a risk here not sending both of these any kobolds. But it's a two-turn clock. If I get my opponent to 10, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright. I guess they can have a slaughter pact. But it's a two-turn clock, plus I get to Sheldock Isle Bribery. And I think I want to do it end of turn. Because... I want to do it end of turn because my opponent could have a sweeper here. I know they could have found, like, a big creature, but... Like, if my opponent found a Damnation or something... Super close one. Yeah, I mean there's like a merit, there's like an argument to be made for Sheldocking Isle there in response to the anticipate, because my opponent could have found Sword of Temptation. Also, they're tapped out, but again, they're playing black. They could have a Wrath. Okay, so I'm going to do this in response now, because my opponent can't Wrath. Alright, what do we have? Oh, Consecrated Sphinx. That's a good one. Let's take a look at the deck, though. Slaughter Pact, Murderous Cut, Karn. Yeah, very nice control deck here. Got a Rune Snag. I think Consecrated Sphinx is pretty good here. I'm gonna go with that. Draw two cards off the Jace activation. Not bad. Gotta just make sure this resolves. Alright. I'm gonna just attack my opponent. If my opponent wants to use Jace with an active Consecrated Sphinx when I have Glen Alindra Archmage up, so be it. My opponent's at 10 life. Wow, what a crazy game! My opponent's deck is definitely favored here. They have more Planeswalkers, which is big. We do have Glen Alindra Archmage. They have Nightfall Spectre. Yeah. Okay. Actually, if my opponent lets my Sphinx die, I think I'll let that happen. I guess they could have Venser. Venser to Consecrated Sphinx. Seems good. Play Consecrated Sphinx. Seems good. All right, you're dead. I think you're dead. So we can go, oh, they have Slaughter Pact. I forgot about Slaughter Pact. So this is basically, like, playing Shadow Mage is basically like activating the Tar Pit because we get to do this. Then we get to attack. I don't think this changes the clock, so let's just get rid of the Jace. All right. Okay, we got there. Whew! That was, all right, all right. Let's see, how are we sideboarding? Let's go deep. So we're boarding in those cards. Kind of want to take out Damnation. The Persecutor is pretty good at pressuring Planeswalkers. I like the instant speed removal. Well, Soul Reap does get anything, though. Soul Reap is a nice way to just... A cheap way to get rid of, like... Sword of Temptation and all that other... All that other stuff. Massacre Worm seems pretty poor. Duplicate also doesn't seem great. Like... Let me take a look. I mean, there is a Consecrated Sphinx that my opponent can play. Nightfall Spectre, Venser. There's not a lot of good duplicate targets. There's a Shadow Mage Infiltrator. But I think Go for the Throat, Soul Reap, Essence Scatter, Ruinous Path is likely good enough. Although now the Persecutor might not be good in the sense that I don't have enough ways to kill it because we got rid of two of the ways to kill it. Currently we just have... what is it? Nicol Bolas and these cards to kill it, so maybe it's just not good. I'm just considering it because my opponent had Planeswalkers, but maybe this is also not great. Although if that's the case, what do we want to do? Here, taking damage doesn't really matter, so I'd probably just give myself the extra red source. But I think I want to replace a swamp with an island because we added a Teferi. And it's possible we just want an extra land. Or we just go with one of these fatties. I guess we'll just go with the duplicate just because. Could also play an extra land, but I think 21 mana sources is good enough. So let's go with this. Let's try this. Actually, you know what? This might be going a little too deep, but I could have also considered splashing green for Trigon Predator and Beast Within. It gives me more outs to Planeswalkers, and the games do go kind of long. And we did have a temple. So that could have been a consideration that, yeah. Oh. I almost didn't do it because I wanted to wait for... The turn before Vendilion click, but I get a Bitter Blossom now. Pretty nice. Oh yeah, that's another reason. Yeah, I definitely should splash the green. My opponent's hand's pretty great though. Wait, they're playing something? Oh, so they don't have a dual land to get here. But they are playing a Shadow Mage Infiltrator if they find a black source. So I hope that they don't find a black source. Alright. Nice. I mean, had it. Probably just going for an Ambitions cost next turn. My opponent's probably playing like a Jace or something. Actually, if my opponent plays a Jace, then maybe I want to... No, never mind. I guess I kind of want to thin out my deck here. Although I wonder why my opponent fetched the island right away. It must be, is this a cryptic command? Yeah. I just don't know why you would telegraph it like that and just fetch. I guess you want to save time. That was my, I should have seen that coming. I should have definitely seen that coming. Well, now I'm just going to play this. What is this? Oh. Jeez. The Planeswalker? Wow. Alright, my opponent took two lands. I'm wondering why they didn't plus it there, but they must have a Fatal Push, which would make this really bad for me. Okay. Man, I thought I was super ahead, but the double counter magic really got me good. Yeah, okay, now we're super behind. And they have Doomblade. So like, I could Sower, but the problem is my opponent has Doomblade. So I'm not really sure what to do. I can go with the long-winded play of Vendilion clicking my opponent to get the Doomblade out of their hand, and then going for Sower of Temptation. But it seems so unlikely to actually work. But I do need to get the Doomblade out of my opponent's hand. Yeah, that's my game plan. Just gonna let my opponent cast all their things. This can't possibly be a counter spell. I guess it could be I guess it could be an Essence Scatter. Or maybe my opponent was looking to Doomblade it. Yeah, this is so sketchy. So sketchy. Yep. And the Sower is in. My opponent's hand is unreal. All right. I cannot beat that hand. Let's just move on. All right. So let's try getting a little fancy here. Let's bring those two in, Temple of Malady and like a forest. Temple of Malady plus forest gives me 2 green, 3 green, 4 green sources. So we can probably cut a swamp because we have Temple of Malady. And then we'd have to cut an island, which makes Teferi a little more questionable. Currently we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 black sources. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 blue sources. Plus 9 and 10. Yeah, we'd have to go to 9 black. It's cutting a lot of black from the deck, but at least we don't have our triple black card anymore. And let's cut duplicate. All right. Oh, wait, no. This is a 17 land deck. We can just play swamp and cut something else. What is our cut, though? See, so I saw a Gilded Lotus. I saw Gilded Lotus and a Bitter Blossom. Maybe the Trigon Predator is not necessary and I just wanted the Beast Within. But this seems like I'm really going out of my way just to have a Beast Within, though. On the play, maybe I don't need the removal as much. We'll see. We'll see how this goes. Scryland, all right. Okay, that's good. Nice. Bitter Blossom? Did not want to see that. But at least we're off to a quick start. We just need to find some threats. Okay. All right. We've drawn lots of cards, and we have a lot of permanents in play. So. Let's play a Wake Thrasher. I mean, this is going to put pressure on my opponent. I don't want to tap my Spear of the Suns, but I'll certainly tap my other cards. Oh, this is good. They're probably... they just plussed. Okay. Okay. All right. Oh, Beast Within wasn't bad. Let's see. Is there any way to... No, I probably just want to play Nicol Bolas, I think. And I hope that my opponent doesn't have Confiscate. Actually, we have Beast Within for that. All right. No shenanigans with Liliana. Wait, now we now have a Giant Weight Thrasher. It looks like my opponent does have the confiscate. No. Okay. That's not bad. That's not bad. Attack my Nicobolas. I don't really care about this Liliana. I think I want to get rid of the Gilded Lotus. Or even Bitter Blossom. Bitter Blossom's kind of annoying too. I mean, I can also kill Liliana with this Ruinous Path. A lot of good targets here. Let's get the Gilded Lotus. Hope my opponent doesn't have a Karn. Alright, I'm gonna go with Ruinous Path here just to put pressure on my opponent's life total. Because my opponent does have a Bitter Blossom on the board. And we do have a Beast Within for, like, a Planeswalker. I see what you're doing. No, that's not actually. If my opponent had confiscate, they would have just confiscated, I think. So it's actually kind of interesting because I am a little bit concerned about confiscate. So I'm actually gonna steal this Fairy Rogue. Guess they could have a Cryptic. Okay, no Cryptic. Just real plain scared here. Steal another flyer. Play a lantern. Land. Play a Trigon Predator and keep up Beast Within. The most scared Nicobolas ever. Hmm. This is a confiscate. Yep. I want my 3/3. I'm just going to attack with everything, not run the numbers. Something has to go here. Alright, and I don't think I saw any wrath, so... just copy this. I wonder how long my opponent had this. They probably, I mean, they didn't have it the turn where Nicol Bolas was 9, I don't think. That would just be super greedy. So, I'm just not sure when they had it. But again, I was just, you know, wanting to be aggressive with my creature, and basically the way I lose is if my opponent top decks a confiscate. At the same time, I could have waited and, or I could have just kept ticking up Nicol Bolas and ultimated the Nicol Bolas, and that probably would have won me the game too. So, yeah, I'm not 100% sure what I should have done there.